आप बोलिए, आप बोलिए।
ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर इज ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग द
मासूम जी, आप बोलिए।
मैडम मैडम
प्लीज, प्रेमचंद्रन जी।
थैंक यू मैडम,
सब जवाब दे दिया। स्पीकर साहब आपसे बात, आपको बात करेंगे। ये सेम बिल है, आप बोलिए
मैडम।
इसका बंद कर
देना
है।
लेट मी एट द आउटसेट कांग्रेचुलेट ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर bringing this law, this comprehensive legislation. So it is a good attempt to cover a legislative vacuum and fill a legislative vacuum and provide for something that was something important that required regulation. Madam, urge to have a child is there for maybe for religious as well as for psychological reasons, because there's a belief that one survives through child. So in that background, so people who are not blessed with the child are prone to or vulnerable for exploitation and have been exploited in absence of a valid law to regulate the assisted reproductive technology. So this, the act, assisted reproductive technology is right law, it's the right step and in the right direction. My friends have pointed to some lacunae which need to be addressed, which need to be thought of by Honorable Minister. The first and foremost is the technical difficulty, because this bill calls surrogacy bill an act, and that law is yet to come, that law is, bill is yet to mature into an act. We know that there are different stages in legislation. That is still a bill. And when in, as was point, when in section 4, section 3, it refers to the national board to be constituted will be section 5 of the Surrogacy Act. That act is yet not in existence. That is yet to come into this. Maybe this may create some kind of a technical difficulty in this to come. Second is that this is, as pointed out by learned speakers, this is discriminatory in some respects, and an effort is required to be made by the Honorable Minister to give a relook and remove those areas, because it leaves out some segments of society that should have been benefited by this act, that should have been and made eligible for benefits of this act, and have been left out. And in that regard, the act is to be given some a relook, and those, the benefits under the act extended to those groups as well. Dr. Hina pointed out that the difficulty in having a male more than 21 years of age having entitled to these benefits under the act is because there is a prohibition in adoption. That does not sound convincing. Though there are reasons that why it was left out, it was because the girl child should not be exposed to some kind of exploitation. That is why adoption was prohibited. But same argument can be dealt with by other means, molding the regulations and by having the regulations so that area is, that problem area is covered. But the benefit cannot be denied. Otherwise, we will keep a segment of the society otherwise entitled to the benefit. Not entitled to the benefit and exposed to the exploitation. Again, that may not be true in case of LGBT. Whatever argument is being put forward to say that no, this benefit should be denied to a male, because who knows that the child may be a girl child, and since the adoption is prohibited, how can that the male have that child? But those can, that argument will not be available in case of LGBT. Again, the act is, I mean, a good, makes a good effort as regards prohibition on pre-implementation genetic testing. But Section 25 of the act keeps pre-implementation genetic testing an open-ended provision, because you say in the provision such other purposes as may be prescribed. Because that makes it open-ended, and that gives a kind of keep a scope for misusing this provision. if you identify the disease for which the pre-implementation genetic testing can be done, you better identify it with certainty than to keep it open-ended. The Act has some important provisions and takes care of some important aspects of the matter. First is that the transfer of to any country outside India, it is Section 30. Section 30 takes care of that problem. Then again, Section 31 is very important because that makes the child born through assisted reproductive technology shall be deemed to be a biological child of the commissioning couple, and said child shall be entitled to all the rights. This is the area, this was the area. Then again, any donor shall relinquish all parental rights over the child or children, because this used to be a question of dispute between the natural child, the donor, and the child or the functioning couple. So these areas are covered, but these areas are covered. And second is, last of all, it is the cost. First, we had advantage. Madam, your speech made us realize that what is the advantage of having an expert in the house. To be very honest about it, we don't know many. I don't know particularly many aspects of the problem that were highlighted by you and that you assist us to understand, because it is a job of experts. And I wish that you are made the first chief of that national board that is contemplated under the Act, and so that you can give disha and direction to this new legislation. But one thing is very important. We were told, madam, by you only, that there are 60 million people who are in the queue, who are not blessed with a child, and who will depend on this, the assisted reproductive technology, and will be indirectly benefited by this Act, saved from the exploitation that is so common in this field. But how this Act should also take care of the cost of this reproductive technology, assisted reproductive technology, unless and until, otherwise it will be a luxury. It will be restricted to a creamy layer, to some of these 60 million people. But what about the people who cannot afford it? So bill should also take care of the cost, or regulate the cost, or provide for some kind of assistance to, say, BPL families or families who are not blessed with a child, who depend on this technology but cannot afford it because they don't have sufficient resources. So this, I would request the Honorable Minister to give a thought to that as well, so that the benefits under the Act become available to that segment of the society as well. Thank you very much.
Sir.
So I have not to add to any, I am in complete agreement with Mr.
A.M. Arif Sahib Ji.